Hi, I'm Todd McCarty. I head up human resources for Cumulus Media and am the CHRO based in Atlanta, Georgia, or at least I was based in Atlanta, Georgia. Our corporate location is split between New York and Atlanta. And so we have we've been a longstanding Buckhead resident as a company. We are an audio first company, so 450 radio stations as well as a radio network. And a number of digital properties.
So about when and why exactly did Cumulus Media become interested in looking at more flexible strategies, including telework, to provide to its employees?
Really, there's a convergence of two things, I would say. One is, I will give credit to Livable Buckhead because putting the topic on the table with us and our membership with Livable Buckhead was something that pushed us, I think, to realize that as we were encountering what I'd call individual situations where we were hiring someone who may not have been in the Atlanta area or may not have been in the New York area or any of the others for us. We were starting to encounter more of those as the workforce became more fluid, but also Livable Buckhead had that on the table as a topic. And so we chose to take the steps to have a more programmatic approach to it rather than true one-offs where we just kind of figured it out along the way. And we were realizing that more of that was to come. We didn't know how much more was to come, but that was really the impetus for us to put together what I'd call more of a program versus we just put an individual situation in place. Our person, Allison Barnes, for working with Livable Buckhead, suggested that we get together a meeting, and I don't know the impetus of that suggestion, but the suggestion was a good one for us to really sit down a few years ago and talk about the resources that you could help provide us. And what came of that meeting was not only some examples of how it could work or how it could be structured, but also some actual physical templates that we were able to work with and then customize in terms of telework agreements, telework do's and don'ts, lots of things that had been in the past, I think, the uncomfortable part of telework, of like, how do you have a conversation about your workspace? How do you have a conversation about how you spend your time? And for both managers and HR alike became, and we made some slight alterations to them, became a set of documents that helped us put actual arrangements in place that were telework and helped form our telework guidelines that we then pushed out to managers. So as they were having the conversations with employees, they could really reference something that had the relevant and pertinent topics to cover. And then for us in HR, our ability to work with managers and employees alike so that everybody was clear about what are the expectations, how is this going to work, and what things do you need to consider before you put something in place.
So we know that challenges have come up throughout the pandemic, not the ones that employers might have thought about lower productivity, but more so about collaboration, connectivity with employees, and keeping employees engaged. So how has Cumulus really kept employees engaged and connected and really allowed for an open line of communication? Have there been specific strategies that y'all have taken?
Yeah. Well, I don't mean to make it all about Zoom or BlueJeans or Teams, Microsoft Teams, but getting some tools in the hands of people that had never used them before was one of the first and fastest things we needed to do. It has taken us time to realize what are the best tools? What are the best venues? I think for all of us, we've learned how to most effectively use those venues, but we have encouraged and migrated, I think, to a point where we want people on screen as much as they can be. We certainly know there's screen fatigue, but in terms of the ability to collaborate and feel connected to people, it has been a huge saving grace that in the days of conference calls would not have been there.